All right, we got a Life for Hire. And by the way, these 100% songs are not actually 100%. It's just broken tracks that need fixins. And yeah. So we're going to go into My Life for Hire. And I could already tell you already, this is a broken track with shitty, probably a really shitty tone. So let's hope for the best. That's all we can do, really. The worst fucking octaves in the world. Do the whole crap core thing. I'm sorry, but you cannot just do that at the very end of the song. Yeah, okay, so here's what I mean by the octaves. Let me pull up the intermission screen just to show you guys. So, octave chords, if you don't know what an octave chord is, it's, So an octave chord is basically, that's an octave, right? Two similar sounding chords, or a note that's an octave. I can't really explain it. If you know what an octave is, it's easier that way. So this would be considered an octave. or this would be considered an octave. See how it's like. Like, that's a normal octave. But where it gets really weird is when you start, like, your classic octave chords, which is, you know, a fret apart, right? So you're skipping a fret and then skipping a string and going to the next fret. But it gets really weird when you start, like, doing the D chord to B chord octaves. Then you're skipping two strings on frets, so... And then you have to translate back. So when I did that whole thing, it's... And on the 7 to 10 octave, you've got to go back to the A8 and then G10. So you're... Catches you off guard a little bit, and it gets really weird at certain points during the song, but I wouldn't say the tone was terrible. It's not overly impressive. Music Theory 101 with Astrid Nebula has every idea what he's talking about, just can't formulate the fucking thought. Like, you see these are octaves.